All right, so Nicole right. Bell, I want to go back to the Pat Robertson thing, because again, we haven't spoken in a few, and I did my year in review, and I realized I had all these Pat Robertson quotes that were so sickening. Did you hear the one about don't adopt kids?
I really didn't, but just hearing Here. That makes my stomach hurt.
Right, this is a man of God, right? Supposedly, God talks to him, although he misheard him on the election on who was going to win, right? He just, he misheard him, right, that's all. But so here's, they're reading, he's got some co-host, I never watch his show, but he's got a co-host, I'm reading a letter, and this woman, to her credit, actually disagrees with him. So here he
Susan goes. Says, I'm the mother of three adopted girls. I find the men I date are okay when I tell them I have three daughters, but when they find out that they're adopted and from three different countries and not my own biological children, they don't want to date anymore. Whether I tell them up front or after a couple dates, all the men are reacting the same way. They say they could be okay if the girls were, you know, biological children and came with child support. Why are these men reacting this way? Can I answer? Because they're, I was going to say dogs.
Don't you insult my
I'm not going to say dogs, but they are. That's just wrong on every level.
No, it's not wrong.
It's wrong.
I mean, a man doesn't want to take on the United Nations, and this woman's got all these various children, and a blended family. I mean, what is it? And you don't know what problems are. I'm serious. I've got a dear friend, adopted some little kid from an orphanage down in Columbia. Child had brain damage. You know, grew up weird, and you just never know what's been done to
grew
a child
weird.
Before you get that child.
Oh
what kind
God.
Of sexual abuse it's been, what kind of cruelty, what kind of food deprivation, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So you're not a dog because you don't want to take on that responsibility. You don't have to take on somebody else's problems. I mean, you really don't. You can go help people. You could minister to people. We minister to orphans all over the world, thousands of them. We love orphans. We love helping people. But that doesn't necessarily mean that I'm going to take all the orphans around the world into my home. And
oh my
I think, you know, okay, let's get the next
That's
question.
True.
I'm in trouble.
Oh, my God.
Oh my God.
Is that, I mean, so he's basically saying, I shouldn't have adopted my daughter because, you know, she's going to grow up weird. Because she spent her first 18 months in an orphanage in Kazakhstan.
Well, I'm just blown away by what an un-Christian statement
you
that
think?
Is.
Well, that's just what I've been saying. I'm an atheist, right. And I'm more Christian than he is.
Right. I'm curious what Pat Robertson would do if he was actually confronted with the corporeal body of Jesus Christ.
Oh, my God.
Because the man was Middle Eastern.
Right, he'd say, you're not Jesus, you're colored.
Right, he's not the white Anglo man that we see in the pictures
right.
with the beard.
Right.
And that's not realistically what would be born, the kind of person that would be born in Bethlehem.
No.
So I'm curious how he would have to deal with the fact that the man that he worships as a god is in fact brown-skinned. Because this is, I mean, frankly, it's just horrifying to me. And, you know, I know you have an adopted daughter.
Yes.
I have an adopted sister. I have my aunt and uncle adopted. Their child is an American and, frankly, was born of a teenage mother who may have done drugs during her pregnancy
right.
as well. But you know what? They love that.
Well, of course. And you know what? There's no guarantees that if you give birth to your own biological child, that child's going to be perfect. That child might grow up weird or brain damaged or have issues. Oh, my God.
Right. And you know what? That we love them anyway. You know, that one of the things that...
All the
I
more reason you bring a kid into your home because this child
right.
had such a horrible beginning that they need love. They need a family, not just your money. Your
right.
Oh, God.
Yeah, and if you are pro-life, this is what you should be doing.
Exactly.
You should be taking in these children.
Exactly.
You know, absolutely.
Absolutely. You don't leave them to rot in an orphanage even if they have money and can feed the kid. Oh, my God. But the other quote... That brought this up today is, well, Pat Robertson thinks we should raise the retirement age because it won't hurt anybody.
So far, the future of Social Security has not been an issue in this year's elections, Pat, but Medicare certainly has.
Well, Lee, they call it the third rail of politics, and politicians just don't have the intestinal fortitude necessary to deal with something that is a looming crisis. When these baby boomers, the baby boomers are turning retirement age, when they begin to retire en masse, they're going to draw down on their private pensions, the 401ks and that stuff, and they're also going to be hitting Social Security hard. Why don't we recognize the fact that people are living longer? I'm sitting here over 80
Lie.
And feel great, riding
well,
horses, you know, lift weights.
You're
and all
rich,
that stuff.
And you sit on your ass all day.
People are living well past 70. When a Social Security is put in effect, most people died in the early 60s. By the time somebody was 65, I mean, he was dead. Now, with medicine and all the nutrition and the support we have in our society, people are living a great deal longer. And consequently, they should be working longer, and they should not begin retirement at age 65 or 66. We should push that retirement age out to 70 or 72. And it's not going to hurt anybody because people really like to work. They don't want to sit around. There's nothing worse than sitting on a rocking chair rusting out. Who needs that?
I'll tell you what's worse than sitting on a rocking chair rusting out is living that long and having no money and not being able to go to the doctor, not being able to pay your rent and food bills and get medicine.
Right. No, I mean, it's just so absurd. And the thing about it is, one, we've had this conversation, there's no crisis in Social Security. No crisis.
Right.
Even if every single baby boomer retired at the exact same time, there are still more people working than there are baby boomers. So this is a non-issue. If you really want to fully fund, and that was the issue, is that, you know, the number of people contributing versus the number of people taking out, the ratio goes down. But if you really want to have that fully funded, you eliminate the income cap, and it's taken care of forever.
Exactly.
There is never going to be a time when it won't be funded. But the thought that people are living longer and that people die, you know, that people died earlier is still, we've had this conversation.
Yes, we just did it, you know, 20 minutes ago.
Right. These people are, when you live in an air-conditioned office and people send you money that you don't have to pay taxes
mm-hmm.
on, yeah, you can keep working until you're 80.
Right, and you can be quite comfortable at 80, mm-hmm. and yes. But the average African-American, the average working-class person, doesn't live that long. And I'll say this again, if I can't get a job at 53, how the hell am I supposed to keep working till I'm 70 or 72?
Right. And this is, you know, and this is the thing, this sounds counterintuitive because we've been so brainwashed by these right-wing memes, but if we really, really wanted to make this work, we don't raise the age, we lower the age. We allow these people to go and get retirement early
mm-hmm.
because, you know, they're at the end of their useful working life, and I'm not trying to say that in a demeaning way, but honestly, I don't want 70-year-old truck drivers
right.
out there. I really
right.
don't.
No, you shouldn't. And no, and you know what? If you worked out long and you paid into the system, you deserve to get it back when you need it. And
right.
these other people, the Tom Brokaws and the Pat Robertsons, can afford to pay a little more to help
right.
those of us who need it.
Right. But if you lower the age to 60, you've just freed up jobs for younger people like you and I who can't find jobs.
That's right. That's
so
right.
It's not, the answers are there. We're just not even approaching them because we're completely operating on these right-wing frames of Social Security is going bankrupt, everybody's living longer, you know, we can afford to raise the age. None of the actual common sense solutions are even being brought to the table.
I hear you. Hey, Nicole Bell, on that note, we are out of time for today. Nicole Bell, back with us every Monday morning for a Fools on the Hill segment. Find her all the time at crooksandliars.com. Thank you. I'll talk to you
great.
Next week.
Okay. All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. All right, don't forget, tomorrow, Congressman Alan Grayson, right here. We'll see you then. Thanks, as always, for listening. And the podcast will be up in a little bit. Share it with your friends, okay? Talk to you tomorrow. radio or not. Bye, everyone.
I see him lurking in bookstores.